Okay, you guys know that was a joke. The Suicide Squad would be absolutely nowhere without the support of the fans. You guys love these characters as much, if not more, than we do. And I truly want to thank you for your passion. Flula, man, I'm sorry, bro. Javelin would have made a great character for a spinoff. Hey, you know what? Maybe we can see him get him involved somewhere down the line on Peacemaker. I mean, no promises. James Gunn created this whole thing for HBO Max, and, you know, he has a vision all worked out. But we'll see what we can do. And if you want to hear more what's in store for Peacemaker, you can join James, myself, and my amazing castmates for some additional insights. Hey, everybody. John Cena here on the set of Peacemaker.
Oh, no!
First. Every time you were shooting, he went, ow!
Why am I doing this?
They said you couldn't get a job.
Get up.
Oh, hi.
23andMe says I might be 26% asshat. I know my last name is Smith. That's a generic fucking name. The reason it's Smith is because we came over as asshats, and I had to change it on Ellis Island.
Hey, everybody, I'm James Gunn. Today, we're talking all things Peacemaker. Of course, I'm joined by my behind-the-scenes partners in crime, executive producers Peter Safran and Matt Miller, and our fantastic cast, Peacemaker himself, John Cena, Danielle Brooks, who plays a character of my own making, Leota Adebayo, Jennifer Holland and Steve Agee, Amelia Harcourt and John Economos, and Chuck Owuji as Clemson Mearn, and finally, Freddie Stroma, who is our vigilante. So, guys, let's get into it.
It goes without saying, I miss you guys. It's great to see you all.
Miss you so much. You too.
John, were you surprised when Peter called you up and said, hey, you know, we're thinking about doing a Peacemaker TV series?
I was surprised, but, man, I was more than ready, and I was more than excited, and I'm glad we got the opportunity.
Freddie, for you, you came in, and you're playing the oddest character of everybody, vigilante Adrian Chase. And you're not that odd.
Yeah, no, I'm so pretty vanilla. I love it. I really, as soon as I started reading the sides, I was just like, oh, I really like this character. And he has just that kind of, you know, a really fun relationship with Peacemaker. And obviously working with John was just incredible.
I've seen Freddie. But for how many of the rest of you are you hearing him talk with a British accent for the first time?
Oh, me.
Yeah.
And I'm like, my brain is melted. I can't believe it.
So, Danielle, why don't you tell us a little bit about your character in general, who she is, and what's her story?
This is all new to her, you know, and so she's coming in very green. She used to work with animals, and now she's been thrown into this completely different world.
You brought her to life. You really did, and you do inhabit a role in a very special way, and it was just so fun to see you flow.
For Harcourt, her relationship with Adebayo, this new member of the team that's coming in and that Harcourt does not trust, it was something really unexpected for me when I met Danielle, and I literally could not hate her. Like, she is just she's the most lovable, warm, wonderful person.
The sisterhood of Harcourt and Adebayo is a wonderful thing to see.
It feels like that's part of, sorry, James.
No, go ahead, Chuck.
The first day we shot, at least I shot in John Cena's trailer, and it was the scene where we all, the team, meet John Cena, and Danielle, you made her continuously improvise, being nervous, and she would, I mean, that improvisation as every, there were tears running down people's eyes, and it went on and on, and Danielle was put on the spot, and the things that were coming out of her, and to the point where off camera, Steve Agee just had to get his camera out and film it.
I was just gonna say, it reminds me of how often working with Steve, you'd, you know, be in a scene and you'd look over behind the camera and there's AG filming you.
This is like my first day with the cat, like all the cast too. And Steve AG is recording. Everybody's laughing. John Cena's holding character. So he's making me nervous. Everything. It was crazy, but it was one of the things I will never, ever, ever forget.
It's okay if you do forget it because I have it all on video.
I freaking love everything about your 6'7" self, however tall you are.
That's about right.
Freddie was such a warm spirit to come into the space as well. Like, you know, even though he was new, he jumped right in fearlessly and worked with us. And Jacuti is the real deal from day one. You're just like, oh my gosh, he elevated all of us to bring our best. So it's been really great getting to work with everybody. And you just really made a girl's dream come true to get to tell this story with you all. And this is not a world that a person like me normally gets to be a part of at all. To have the action portion and also the depth of a person, I am so thankful for you.
I love you. I just think you're the greatest. Although, you know, I'm surprised you did give Chuck so many, you know, compliments, because you would often come over to me and say, you know, that you know, I was supposed to tell Chuck to watch you to see how it's done.
Oh, everybody had to get on my level.
James, I remember you said to me on set one day that only Eagly competed with Chuck in terms of being a really great actor. You said that was only one.
I think we have not brought up Eagly, who, of course, steals the show.
He's Peacemaker's pet eagle, and he's Peacemaker's best friend. As a dowel with some green tape on it, Eagly stole the show.
Yeah, that's true.
I also got to say that this is probably the third or fourth thing I've worked with James on, and I've never seen him more giddy working on something in my entire life. I mean, there was one night we were shooting, and the whole time, it was like 3 a.m, and James is just running around laughing like a maniac, and he kept saying, I can't believe they're letting me shoot this.
Yeah, that's the happiest night of my life. I'm like, that was Warner Brothers' funeral that they let me do that. We'll see.
I have one. I mean, this is, I believe, the only show that has John Cena dancing for 4 minutes in his tighty whities to the Choir Boys. I don't believe there's ever been a show that offers that up.
The memorable tighty whities.
Okay, so we're going to be taking some questions from the fans. These came from Instagram and Twitter. So at Remy.C.L asked, was there any characters you wanted to put in Peacemaker but couldn't? I guess that's a question to me. The answer is no. I got to put it in every character I wanted to. For John Cena, at PopSignite asks, what was the most difficult part of becoming Peacemaker?
I think it was just getting comfortable being a super asshole. I'm normally just a normal asshole. And I think just being a high-octane asshole was probably the most difficult part.
Was that really difficult? Because it seemed to come to you pretty easily. Okay, here's a big question. I guess we can throw this to Matt and Peter. What can we expect for the show? Ask at MagicCM1210.
Well, I mean, I think what we can expect is a truly original superhero show. James wrote all 8 episodes. He directed 5 of the 8. And it's just got that unique tone that James brings to all the content that he creates. So I think it's something pretty special.
Yeah, I would also just add to that that with the action and the spectacle and the emotion and the comedy is also like this workplace comedy at the center of it, about all of these characters that kind of come together. It's like The Office as a superhero show.
With more people getting shot in the face than in the office.
Occasionally, yeah.
So, at Smruti Anmol asks, is Peacemaker going to go through a journey of changing from a jerk to a lovable hero in the series, or will he remain that crazy, not-to-be-trusted liberator? That's kind of a spoiler.
I was going to say, questions that can't be answered. That's perfect. It's right up my alley. We just can't give anything away. You'll have to watch and see on HBO Max.
What about the rest of you? What did you feel about, you know, seeing Peacemaker's journey on this show?
Can't really say much. So there's definitely great character arcs that you will thoroughly enjoy as an audience.
You root for him regardless of his past, and you hope that he will change. And I just thought that was such an interesting thing to explore with the series.
I think one of the interesting things about Adebayo and Peacemaker is that on paper, they seem very different. They seem like polar opposites, but they actually have a ton of things in common. And one of the things that they're both dealing with is loyalty versus morality. And
not disappointing people that mean the most to them and finding the beauty in each other, even though their worlds are completely different. So that was a lot of fun to play with and definitely added to the layers of our two characters.
That's extremely well said.
She's the only one he gets along with. She's the only one that thinks he's funny, you know?
Right.
She laughs at him. She throws up, blows off the stuff that he says that's stupid and realize he's an ignorant asshole. And that, to me, is really special because it is so much of what the show is about.
Yeah.
It was amazing, and I'm just grateful to be a part of this crew because no one came in with an ego. Nobody came in with a chip on their shoulder, but everyone comes in with a history, with something to offer, with a set of skills, and it's a bold step. James, you're taking a step into trying to grow the genre, and we're gonna do it with 8 episodes and hopefully we have more. But everyone has their moment, and that certainly comes from your writing.
Really quickly, there was a sense of, you know, we're gonna have fun doing this. So that really helped. And that came top down. The shit rolls downhill, you know?
It's been such a great experience and such a fun, massive experiment that, you know, I just can't wait to share it with the fans, you know, DC fans and just fans in general.
Yeah, I want to say thank you, everybody, for giving us all so much time. I really appreciate it. I hope everybody's well, and I hope to see everybody soon.
Good to see you,
guys.
Everyone.
Miss you.
Miss you guys.
Oh, man, thank you guys so much for all your questions. I'm stoked to see that you guys are so excited about the series, almost as excited as I am. I know I had a great time. I hope you guys did. But before we let you go, I have a little surprise for you. It's an exclusive, never-before-seen first look at a Peacemaker teaser.
Jamil, you cool?
What does that mean?
Truth is, I'm supposed to be in prison.
For what?
Superhero stuff.
What superhero are you?
Peacemaker.
Get out of here! There's no superhero called Peacemaker!
Dude, I'm famous.
You're a born killer with expertise in every weapon known to humankind. I'm giving you the chance to stay out of prison and work for me.
Kill people.
Bad people.
This is Harcourt. Your handler in the field. John Economist, Tech and Tactics. And this is our new recruit, Adebayo.
You don't have to shoot people after you already killed them.
Right. Who's the guy that's peeking out behind the trash can?
Vigilantes, trying to be helpful.
Our first target is Senator Roiland Goff. Goff may be traveling with his family.
Are you sure those two kids came out of those parents? That's an attractive couple, and that one looks like it came out of them, but the other one looks like a butt baby.
A butt baby.
Yeah, my older brother told me there's two types of babies. One that comes out normal, and then butt babies. Worse in every way, they come out of a woman's butt. No, I believed I was a butt baby until I was like 14.
That explains a lot. There's something about him that's sad.
Hey, Dad.
You got it, my sperm. Going to a Nancy boy like you.
You know, lately I'm just thinking of a maniac.
No! No!
That's because we're born killers. What separates us from other killers is we only kill bad people. Usually. Unless there's a mistake.
You use being a jerk as a way to push people away.
You suck at PowerPoint!
But if you would just drop that, people actually might like you.
Dad, grab my phone. I don't want to move. Dad?